Good morning. Today's the day. I went out and sprayed last night. We prepped the drills last night also. And it's hammer down time. Let's do it. So here's the old bud that we use for miscellaneous things like plowing washouts, plowing ruts up. And Grandpa said he would be willing to go up and start plowing up where we're gonna start seeding. I just sprayed it last night. So, you guys ready to hear what a big cam, a really old big cam sounds like and looks like? Great for what we use it for. That's why we keep it around. And off he goes. They grow up so fast. Let's go put some seed in the ground.
I'm just looking down. There's a hard current over here. Yeah, this is a hard current. He says, I have to swim pretty hard, he says.
Hello, peeps. Back to a new day. It's been, oh, a couple days now. We got a really big snowstorm, praise the Lord. Everything is wet, and we haven't been able to do anything, but we're finally now thinking we can get in the field and get these girls going. So, that's what we're gonna do. I filled the buggies just a second ago. Just spotted them up at the field where we're going to. So Dad and I are gonna move up the highway and go spray. Good stuff. Updated way to keep records. It is really, really, really fantastic. So all these iPads are connected to the cloud live. So everything that I'm doing right now is instantly being shot to the cloud. Same with Dad, he's right over here spraying. Same thing, all being shot to the cloud, keeping it in one spot all the time. But the things that you can do with it, so right now, like I'm spraying a field that's called West McAlpine. We have all of our fields loaded into here, yada, 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 whichever one you want to choose. You choose your field, obviously the year is 2024, and this is what we have selected as our application, is ChemFollow. ChemFollow is our certain mix, and I'll show you that here in a minute. But right here, this is how you adjust your map. So like right now, I'm looking at the application rate. I can look at the application mix, the sprayer speed, and the product rate. Like if I want to see where RT3 is put down, aka Roundup, there's that. The dicamba or Weedmaster that we're putting on, along with the 2,4-D, and the liquid AMS that we're putting on. I can also see where it's been applied across the field and where it varies. Like you can see the sprayer like going around these power poles right here. You can see it was varying in little spots there. And you can see the aim command working to keep up and do its best to keep a steady, even rate across the entire field. It's pretty dang cool. I really, really like it. I usually just keep it on the application page there so I can just see where the whole sprayer is applicating, where, how much, and when. The way this connects to the sprayer is through this little puck right here. The way this works, it's just a bracket that mounts on the back of the Pro 700. It extends out, and there's a wiring harness up underneath here, which then plugs into the Pro 700, into the puck. So then whatever the Pro 700 reads, the puck also reads, which then sends it automatically straight up to the field view. The other thing that's really, really cool with this is you can build prescriptions off of this. So like we can do an entire year, go cut the crop, see where it's yielded, see what was different, what was better. You can judge a prescription off of the vegetation map. Every, oh, probably 2 weeks, I would say-ish, give or take, you know, it could be a little more, a little bit less, the satellite will move over us and snap pictures of the entire farm. That will then get sent into our Climate Field View app. We can look at it and it will give us a map of the entire field where there is more vegetation, less vegetation, where it's drier, something doesn't look right. Like, we know guys who have Climate Field View, and run irrigation. They then got their satellite image, looked at it, and said, what the heck, why is there one little red stripe around the entire field there where our pivot runs? So they went out there and investigated, and there was a plug nozzle on their irrigation pivot, so that little section wasn't getting water, and FieldView caught it. So a couple cool things with FieldView as far as spraying goes. I'm mostly talking to my farmers here. You can generate records off of this. So right now the sprayer is recording the wind, the humidity, all of it, where it's coming from, whatever. So let's say you're spraying something in your tank mix that's supposed to kill a certain type of weed, and all of a sudden you find out that it killed your whole crop. And something went wrong, yada yada. So then you call up the company because you know you're gonna be ticked off like any other farmer would be. They will then say, well, let's see your spray record or whatever. You can go right into here, hit boom, application summary, and here it all is. It tells you what you put on, what ounces per acre, your wind speed, all the above, yada yada yada, the direction, the temperature, etc. I would highly recommend FieldView to anyone. I'm going to try and stay winged out, lift up my booms all over these fence posts right here, across the highway onto that field. I feel like I've done it in the past, but I'm not totally sure, so I'll let you know how it goes. Check out this rig. That wide angle lens doesn't do justice. That thing's huge. 120 foot booms is wild. Couldn't even imagine 135. Jeez. You guys alive? Oh, you are alive. I'll be darned. Thought for sure my camera would have died by now. I need to get a better camera setup. So if you guys have a good one that's pretty durable, hit me in the comments, would you? Seriously, because I'm really not liking my GoPro anymore. So. There we go. Just like that, my battery's gonna die, so I'm gonna say it quick. 1,000 acre spray, just like that. Home, back at the yard with a